As you may know, the eagerly awaited results for the banking sector are unfolding. What we already know is that the majority of the private sector banks are witnessing modest growth, except for outliers such as HDFC Bank and ICICI Bank, with their double-digit growth rates year-on-year in advances. Oh, and I hope you have your chai ready, because there's a lot more unpack here. Hi, this is Viral Shah, and today let's deep dive into the tumultuous waters of the banking sector. Incoming trends indicate the fact that private sector banks have gained market share from PSU banks. How this for a fact? Private sector banks' loan books clocked an 18% CAGR over the past 5 years in comparison to public sector banks fetching 4% CAGR. That's not all. Deposits across private sector have seen robust growth in Q1 FY22. HDFC Bank, ICICI Bank, IndusInd Bank, Bandhan Bank in particular have led the charge. And although private banks have registered healthy profits, there has been a stark increase in the retail slippages, predominantly in the form of defaults on gold and agricultural loans. The reason for higher slippages from gold loans can be attributed to the loan-to-value ratio for gold loans that have moved back to 75% from 90% as per RBI regulations. However, customers didn't pay the excess amount due to the lockdown. Let's look at some of the slippages registered by the banks. ICICI Bank, India's largest private sector bank. While slippages have been valued at INR 72 billion, retail and business have contributed to over 90% of this amount. Within retail slippages, agriculture and jeweler loans have been top contributors. The bank on its part has clarified that jewelry loans are fully secured with negligible losses and gold loans are expected to be recovered soon. Federal Bank has a different story, with asset quality variability being a core concern. Slippages have been valued at rupees 6.9 billion, largely consisting of SMEs, the agro segment and gold loan borrowers. HDFC Bank is another bank to fit the same pattern, with its slippages amounting to rupees 73 billion. And again, the agriculture sector is a major contributor at rupees 9 billion. The retail segment contributed 80% of the total slippages incurred by Axis and IndusInd Bank respectively. Though there is a disparity between their total values. Axis Bank slippages are worth rupees 65 billion and IndusInd Bank slippages are at rupees 28 billion. And lastly, we have Kotak with relatively low slippages of rupees 15 billion, which came on the back of secured assets. Don't let this endless slippage talk let you think there's no silver lining. There is. Higher than usual slippages seem to be a temporary trend, and banks have steadily improved their collection to the pre-COVID levels. We should expect better results in Q2 of FY22. Except for Bandhan Bank, gross non-performing loans remain more or less stable following the withdrawal of Supreme Court's order to classify loans as standard assets and not NPAs. All the private sector banks continue to follow the prudent provisioning process during Q1 FY22. And while the economy may face a temporary dip due to the second COVID wave, the RBI has forecasted a GDP growth of 9.5% in FY22. And that augurs well for the long-term demand outlook. However, the pace of vaccination is likely to cushion the impact on the earnings front. We expect a gradual return to normalized business traction to be positive for banks. During Q1 FY22, stronger private banks are showing better growth led by strong capital base, provision buffer, superior asset quality, and retail-focused portfolio. The recent wave of capital raising was positive for strengthening bank balance sheets. Gradually reducing the liquidity buffer will be a great support for margin and medium-term return ratios of the banks. Investors should prefer retail-focused private banks as they are well-capitalized, have superior asset quality, and have created a substantial provision buffer. We believe that they have the potential to gain market share as the situation normalizes. And that's all for the day. This is Viral Shah signing off. Happy investing. Please do not consider this as a recommendation. We suggest investors do their own research and analysis or consult a financial advisor.